we are ready to learn about the one-way chi-square test. Goodness of fit with random expected values. A situation where the expected values are occurring randomly, so the observed values should show no preference for one group over another. Let me tell you more about what I mean. As you make your way through the world, notice how often you have choices to make. Which type of bagel will you choose from among all of these selections? Which one of these various types of soft drinks will you choose from the soda fountain? Which one of these four types of coffee will you choose at the coffee shop? Not all bagels are equally popular. Some are chosen frequently, others get left behind in their bins. But whether it is coffee or soft drinks or bagels, how could you measure whether people truly have a preference or simply choose them randomly? Suppose that six types of soft drinks are served in a soft drink fountain. Are all of them equally popular? What you are asking is whether one type is preferred over the others. So you will assume all of the options are chosen randomly, with no preference for one over the other. Now, if you assume that all six types of soft drinks served in the fountain are equally popular, that means that soda drinkers show no preference for one over the other. Might as well be random. Six types of soda, chosen randomly, means that each one should be chosen 1/6 of the time. So your expected value for each drink will be 1/6, or N over K. If you're not sure, but aren't given other information, use this strategy. In fact, let us apply this strategy with the three-bear chi-square. A family of bears wants to know which of their chairs is most comfortable. They ask a classroom of 120 red-cloaked schoolgirls to sit in each of the three chairs and say which one they prefer. 27 chose Papa Bear's chair. 41 chose Mama Bear's chair. And 52 chose Baby Bear's chair. Do the data indicate any significant preferences among the three chairs? Do the data indicate any significant preferences among the three chairs? Let's work through the five steps of hypothesis testing. Step number one, select the appropriate statistic. We are comparing proportions from a single sample, obtained, to what we expect to find in the population, expected. We will use the one-way chi-square goodness of fit test for no preference. Step two, state the null and the alternative hypotheses. In this case, our obtained values are being compared to an assumption that there is no preference in the population. If the chairs are chosen randomly, then all chairs should be chosen equally often. The null hypothesis is H0, chairs are chosen randomly. And the alternative hypothesis is H1, chairs are not chosen randomly. Step three, select a level of significance. As with our previous research, we assume the alpha is 0.05, two-tailed test. Except all chi-square tests are one-tailed, so we'll just skip that. The degrees of freedom equals K minus 1, where K is the number of categories in your sample. We have three chairs, so the degrees of freedom equals 2. To find the critical value, go to the chi-square values table, found on the last page of your notes. For an alpha level of 0.05 with 2 degrees of freedom, the critical value is 5.99. Chi-squared values greater than 5.99 indicate that the chairs are not chosen randomly. Step 4, calculate the statistics. Let's begin with the formula for chi-square. We're going to use this formula for each chair, so we will do it 3 times. Now, doing a chi-square by hand is easiest if we make a table of the data. We need five columns, which I will number 1 through 5. And this will help us apply the formula each time that we use it. We will begin with the observed values, the number of votes for each chair, which we will put in the O column, O for observed. Now we need the expected values. We need to divide N, or the total sample size, by K, the total number of choices, to get the expected value for each category. We received 120 votes, and you could determine this by either adding up the O values or just read it from the word problem. We assume that there is no preference among the three chairs, so each one should be chosen equally by the 120 red-cloaked schoolgirls. Divide N by K to get each expected value. And conveniently enough, the N of 120 divides easily by 3, leaving us with an expected value of 40 for each chair. And, good news, all of our expected values are greater than 5. Now, obviously, these observed values differ from the expected values, but do they differ statistically significantly? To find out, we will subtract each expected value from its respective observed value. And that gives us column 3. Now, this is a good time to do a data check. The O minus E column should always add up to 0. Now, this makes sense because the O values add up to N, total sample size, and the E values also add up to N. So we are subtracting N minus N. The total should be 0. Well, now we square each value in column 3. And that gives us the fourth column. For the fifth column, we will divide each value in the fourth column by E. Now for this test, all of the expected values are the same, 40. So we divide all of the fourth column values by 40. Notice how when the O and E values are similar, the chi-square values are small. The more that the observed deviates from the expected, the larger the chi-square values. Now the last step is to add up the fifth column. Those values add up to 7.85. That is our chi-square statistic. Now let's go back to our 5 steps of hypothesis testing. Step 4, calculate the statistics. The total chi-square was 7.85. Step 5, make the decision. Compare the chi-square value of 7.85 to the critical value, 5.99. Since the chi-square value exceeds, it is further from 0, than the critical value, the results are statistically significant. Reject the null hypothesis that says that the chairs are chosen randomly. The chairs are not chosen randomly. Chi-square with 2 degrees of freedom, N of 120 equals 7.85, probability less than 0.05. And here is a sample APA write-up for our one-way chi-square goodness of fit test. A chi-square goodness of fit test was conducted to determine if crimson-cloaked schoolgirls showed preferences for the type of ursine chair. Expected frequencies in all cells were greater than 5. There was a statistically significant association in the type of chair. Chairs were not chosen randomly. Chi-square, 2 degrees of freedom, N of 120, equals 7.85, p less than 0.05.